Hey guys, thanks for tuning into the channel. This week's video is all about maintaining that zone 2 with a little bit of interval work thrown in there. See if I have any troubles with my heart rate monitor and see if it fixes itself. Me don't know. But anyway, enjoy this week's video and we will see you at the end. Hey, good morning everybody. So welcome back into the video series. This week is the start of the 9th week. Can you believe it already? It's been 9 weeks that I've been doing this. So today is another interval day. We got a 15 minute warm up and then 3 sets of 5 minutes in zone 4 with a 2 minute rest in between and then a cool down. So it's another beautiful day here. Yes, shorts and t-shirts still in December. We've made it into December. I'm still in shorts and a t-shirt. Gotta love it down here. But, you know, hey, come August, it's gonna be miserable again. But for now, I'm taking what I can get. So, hope you all enjoy today. Like I said, it's a 15-minute warm-up and then 3 sets of 5 minutes at the threshold pace, zone 4, and then a 2-minute cool-down in between each set. So, shouldn't take too long to get done, about a half hour or so. So, hey, here we go, getting the warm-up done. All right, boys and girls, there you got. That's it. That was the workout. Nothing to show, really, because it's kind of hard to film while you're doing intervals. You know, trying to monitor heart rate and everything like that. So, but, no, it felt good today. Knees still a little wonky. As you can tell, I still got some head cold thing hanging on here, so... Chainsaw off in the distance, but so interval training, you want to try to find that pace where you can comfortably stay in the higher zones without creeping into the zone above. Like today I was supposed to be in zone 4, I kept bouncing into zone 5 every now and then. So finding that pace that you can run comfortably, that's the key to the interval training there too. The other thing that was happening is when I'm sick, you know, and I'm cold, got a cold going on, your heart rate's already elevated a little bit because of that. So all of my running today seemed a little harder just because harder to breathe, got the nose all plugged full of stuff, and you know, just heart wasn't feeling that good. You know, it's just kind of a yucky run, but I got it done. Pushing through a cold is something totally different than pushing through an injury. Or a possible injury. So if you think you've got an injury, don't push it. But if you got a cold, I say go out and run, you know, run that cold out of you. But that's gonna be it for today, guys. Again, it is Thursday. It is the start of the 9th week of this training program. Doing intervals with a cool down. Nice, easy day. Didn't feel the greatest in the world, but you know, not every run's gonna be awesome, so. But I tell you what, this weather's pretty awesome. All right, guys, catch you again on Saturday.
Well, here we are. It is Saturday, and today it is what I call a ladder workout. So it'll be 6 minutes in zone two, 6 minutes in zone three, 6 minutes in zone four, and then 6 minutes back down to zone two again. So we're building off of the different levels there, and I'll put a picture up probably at the end of my run to show you guys kind of what the heart rate's doing as it is climbing through those different zones there. So I'm just gonna do a quick little warm up and then we'll get out and hit that run. It's a beautiful Saturday morning down here in the desert. Yeah, December, shorts and a t-shirt. Can't really beat it.
All right, so here I am just a few minutes in. Nice easy jog, you know, not going very hard, not going very fast. Talking easy, you know, not laboring on breath. But my watch is saying I'm in the 150s. There's no way. Absolutely no way. If I was in the 150s, I wouldn't be able to talk the way I am. It's gotta be the heart rate monitor. It's gotta be the, yeah, see, 155 again. Come on, somebody buy me a new one. Please, pretty please. All right, so there's the run, it is done. I took the heart rate monitor off about halfway through, thinking that that was causing the issue. But what I think happened now is that it was never connected in the first place. So when I took it off, the heart rate didn't change at all. So it just stayed the same, highly elevated. Even when I went into zone three and four, it was elevated even higher than my perceived effort. So where I thought I was compared to where the heart rate was saying, two totally different things. You know, zone four, I feel like I was running in zone four, but my heart rate was in like zone five. You know, it was like maximal effort, but I could still talk. And literally now when I'm walking, goes the car, it happens. But literally now while I'm walking, I'm in the 130s. Don't know how that happens, but heart rate on the watch is slowly going down. So I'm thinking that the heart rate monitor on the watch, not the greatest way to measure. And I'm not sure exactly why the heart rate monitor did not pair this morning, but evidently it did not. So anyway, still a good run, good day. Sun is shining, shorts and a t-shirt. Can't really complain other than malfunctioning equipment, but it happens. You gotta adapt and overcome. So, all right, y'all, have a great Saturday, and I will see you again on Tuesday. Good morning, everybody. It is Tuesday, and today it is a long run day. So we are in zone two for 50 minutes, 50 minutes. So this is by far the longest run that we have done on this training program. So heart rate monitor is saying that it is connected, so we shall see how that lasts through the whole workout. But it is a, like I said, a 50 minute run in zone two. So you know, another beautiful day. Little chilly this morning, just a little bit, but perfect for running. So not gonna need anything other than shorts and a t-shirt. I was thinking maybe I was gonna put on some little mittens, but I'm gonna be a champ and not do it today. So hey, there we go. So today, like I said, 50 minutes, zone two, keeping it low and slow, building that cardio aerobic base. So here we go, guys.
Have a great Tuesday. See you after the run. There you have it, guys. Today is Tuesday. That was the run. 50 minutes in zone 2, and I gotta say, I don't know why, but the heart rate monitor worked perfect today. No breaks, no interruptions. I'll put my pictures right over in here somewhere that shows like my pace, because I could definitely feel my pace getting slower and slower and slower and slower, but my heart rate stayed pretty consistent. There was a couple times it jacked up, but one time towards the end there, it was because I was having to cross the street, major intersection, before the crosswalk sign said don't walk anymore. So, but yeah, all in all, it was a great day for the run. Everything worked out perfect. Great way to end the week of running and filming for this. So, yeah, everything worked out great. I'm not sure exactly how far I went. I'm thinking somewhere around 7 miles, somewhere in there. I'll put my total mileage right up there for you so you can see what I did. But I'll put links to my Strava and to my Garmin down in the description if I can figure out how to do that. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this week's video. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up, the subscribe, and the bell notification. That way you get notified each and every time that I post a new video. Every Wednesday I'm pumping one of these out for you guys. Hopefully it helps inspire you to get out and start running and you learn a few things along the way. So thanks again for watching, and until next time, have a great day.